Praise God for this time that we are about to go into some time of warfare. I thank Pastor Light for giving us this opportunity to be with the people of God and to pray. The Bible say, men ought not to sleep, men ought to always pray. Praying is not for boys, praying is for men. Bible says men ought to always pray. So we are going to go to prayer. I want to talk about the divine settlements. Divine settlements, settling the things. There are things that have to come to end, especially this coronavirus. We have to pray that things must come to an end. I want to read from the book of Mark chapter 4. No, particularly from verse 35 to 39, but I'm going to focus on just 39. It's a story about Jesus Christ with a disciple being on the boat while Jesus was asleep. The Bible said there arose a storm. And there arose a storm. And then the disciple cried to Jesus. They said, Master, carest thou now that we are perishing? But the Bible said Jesus woke up. When he woke up, and he went and he rebuked not the storm, he rebuked the wind and he spoke to the sea. He didn't rebuke the sea. He didn't rebuke the storm, but he rebuked the wind because he knows that what is causing the storm is the wind. If he rebuked the storm, the wind will cause another storm to come. But if he rebuked the wind will not cause any more storm to arise. So this is what I want us to pray. First of all, we're going to begin by rebuking the wind that is behind this COVID-19. The COVID-19 is the crisis. We can say that COVID-19 or COVID-21, this virus is what we can say, it's the storm that we are finding ourselves. But behind it, there's a vehicle. Behind it, there is something that is pushing it. Behind it, there is evil forces. Mm-hmm. There is evil intentions. There are evil people. There is evil agenda that is behind it. We're not rebuking the storm, but the wind. Everything that is behind these evil viruses. Because if we stop the wind, the storm will be vanquished. The storm will come down. There will no more be any storm. There will no more be anything. So we want to talk about divine settlement. Let the Lord settle this storm. Let us rebuke the wind that is behind COVID-19. Let's pray in the name of Jesus. Father God, we come against every power that is behind this COVID-19. Every wind that is contrary, every Euro Clinton wind, every vehicle that is pushing, every agenda of the enemy, we come against it in the name of Jesus. We rebuke the wind in the name of Jesus. We rebuke every power, every person, every spirit, every lodges, every organization, Freemason, Rosicrucians, every ruler, every principalities that are trying to advance, that are hiding in the shadows, that want this virus to continue to cause havoc. We rebuke them in the name of Jesus. We rebuke them. Let every vehicle that is bringing up fear, every vehicle that is bringing up stress, let it go back in the name of Jesus. We rebuke them. We rebuke them.
And we don't let them come
in the name of Jesus.
Don't let them come, the living God, as they will say, that Jesus Christ
is trying to promote fear, trying to cause havoc.
Jesus Christ will come again, then he will pray over the nations.
We come against them,
and the nations will come against them, so they will be installed
against them in the name of Jesus.
Antichrist will be installed.
I want to make this declaration that all those who are behind this virus, whether it is people, whether it is spirits, whether they are hiding, wherever they are, may the Lord expose them in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord. Amen. Now, let us turn now in the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 24. Book of 2 Samuel, chapter 24. I'm going to particularly just read from verse 15 and 16, 2 Samuel 24. I want to show you something that is very interesting. The Bible says that David took a census. When he took a census, the hand of the Lord, the wrath of the Lord was kindled up against David. And then God began to strike. From verse 16, the Bible says that, so the Lord sent a plague upon Israel from the morning till the appointed time, from Dan to Beersheba, 7,000 men of people died. And the angel stretched out his hand over Jerusalem to destroy it. The Lord relented from the destruction and said to the angel who was destroying the people, "It is enough. Now restrain your hand." The angel of the Lord was by the threshing floor of Arona, the Jebusite. So what we see here, the Bible talks about the plague. People could see the plague. But in the spiritual realm, the plague was the beating or the striking of the angel of death. In other words, what people are seeing, we're giving it even names, COVID-19, COVID-21, we're giving it even names and all of these things. But in the spiritual realm, there is an angel behind it. There is an angel of death behind it. There is an angel of death behind it. And we are going to speak like the word the Lord said here in verse 16. We are going to say enough. We are going to say no more loss of life. We are going to say, you angel of death, the Lord has mercy on us. And he has said enough. No more further. You don't move anymore. You don't cause havoc anymore. You don't torment us anymore. Let your hand be stayed. Let your hand stay. Let your hand be moved. Let these evil intentions, let all your plan that you are bringing about behind this COVID-19, let it cease in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Let's begin to say to the angel of death, no more loss of life. No more loss of life. No more loss of life. Stay your hand. Stay your hand. Let's pray in the name of Jesus. Stay your hands. It is enough. Restrain you from striking God's people. In the name of Jesus, you will not go any more further. No more death in the hospitals. No more death in our cities. Is there anybody praying with me right now?
Yes, my Lord. Mama Shaka Bago Tiara Bashaka. No more death.
Let's command the angel of death to stop. Let's command the angel of death to go.
Healing, my Lord, my God, of the influenza which is
the life, my Lord.
Of which is the name of
the Lord. In the name of Jesus. You have had your time. You have had your time. The Lord has mercy on us. And he has declared
I cannot find out anymore, my Lord. Enough is enough.
In the name of Jesus.
Now we are in the name we pray. Amen.
We are staying in this dimension because I said today I want to pray, I want to lead as to speaking about divine settlement. Now we are continuing in this dimension. What we are going to pray right now, we are going to say that no more demonic surprises. We are going to deal with demonic surprises. We are going to deal with everything of shocks, everything that of suddenness. You know, today you find out that they're speaking about the first wave, and then tomorrow you find out again they're talking about another wave, the third wave. When are they going to go forward with these things? We are going to say any unforeseen situation, let it not see the day. Let it from the womb of the day be averted, be aborted. No more unexpected things. Oh, they're talking about virus today, and then next time you talk vaccines today, and then you find out later, then they tell you that the vaccine are not good enough, they are not trustworthy, or if you get it, then you have to get another one. So they are unstable. We want to pray that God will stabilize things. And first thing we're going to declare, no more demonic surprises, no more unexpected news, no more unforeseen situation, when it concerns this vaccine, let the Lord settle stuff. No more surprises in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray in the name of Jesus. In what concerns the vaccine, in what concerns the government, in what concerns the dealing of this virus, we come against demonic surprises, Lord my God. We come against every rude awakening. Settle the matter. Stop it, my Lord. No more unexpected news. The devil will not take your people by surprise. The devil will not take the leaders by surprise. The devil, and what concerns this virus, he will not take us
even forces,
God. He will not catch us
even forces, my Lord and my God.
In the name of Jesus,
we
bind every surprise behind this virus. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' mighty name, and the same Jesus sent him.
Can we take the book of Exodus? The book of Exodus, chapter number 10. Exodus, chapter number 10. And we are going to deal with the west wind. The west wind. Number 10, from verse 13, the Bible says, in verse 13, the Bible says that the Lord sent the east wind to bring about the locust. So Moses stretched out his rod over the land of Egypt, and the Lord brought an east wind on the land of on the land all the day and all the night. It was morning. The east wind brought about the locust. That was the east wind that brought about the locust, which we could say that the east wind brought about this coronavirus. But in order to counter the east wind, the Lord sent a west wind. That is in verse number 19. Verse 19, the Bible says, and the Lord turned a very strong west wind, which took the locusts away and blew them into the Red Sea. There remained not one locust in the territory of Egypt. We are going to pray that if this virus came with the east wind, let the Lord send the west wind. The west wind is the wind of restoration. The west wind is the wind that goes contrary to the east wind in order to stabilize. We are going to say, Father God, blow the west wind that this virus will move, not in Africa. We'll go to the place where those people that have consumed evil for us, they will enter into their own places. It will vanish in Africa. It will vanish all over the world. It will vanish. Let the Lord send the west wind. Begin to pray right now. Begin to ask God for a west wind, the wind of restoration, the wind that goes contrary to the east wind. Let's begin to pray right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, let the wind of the Lord, the west wind, avert. Let the wind of the Lord avert. Let the wind of the Lord divert, avert the virus, this plague, in the name of Jesus. Somebody pray.
Bring healing to
Mighty God, we pray.
Through your west wind, my Lord and my God,
send the west wind.
In all the nations,
that he will bring healing.
Stop it, my Lord and my God.
Bring restoration.
That
it will blow away this coronavirus in the face of the earth. In the name of Jesus.
Of the Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Send an earth. Let it be blown away
west wind.
In
the name of Jesus. We divert the power of this virus. We divert it. We
divert powerfully, my Lord and my God.
We divert. We divert it. We send it back to sender. We send it where it comes from. We divert it.
Send
we
the west wind
declare, let it boomerang,
which comes
in the name of Jesus,
blows all the evil
in the name of Jesus,
the people who planned it, put the people in behind, my Lord and my God. Let it fall over them, let it fall about
in Jesus' mighty name.
The witchcraft, about the Illuminati and Freemasoners and all the people behind it.
Amen.
Come back to them. Let the wind blow to them. Amen.
Psalm chapter number 7. Psalm chapter number 7. From verse 9. Psalm.
What is
number 7? Verse 9. It says something important. It says, oh, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end, but establish the just. For the righteous of God test the hearts and the mind. Amen. Hallelujah. the wickedness of the wicked must come to an end.
Yes,
Lord. The wickedness of the wicked must come to an end. I said today when I was preparing this, the Lord said to me, let's pray about divine settlement. Let the wickedness, the counsel of the enemy come to an end. The manipulation of the enemy come to end. The threats of the enemy come to end. When Goliath came, challenging, defying the children of Israel, in order for God, in order for that threat to come to an end, God had to send a David. God had to send a David to put an end to the defying, to the defiance, everything that is standing in the defiance of the church, everything that is standing in the defiance because of this coronavirus, let it come to an end. Begin to praise Psalm chapter 7, verse 9. Begin to decree and declare the threats to come to an end, the manipulation to come to an end, the intimidation to come to an end, the frustration to come to an end, the plotting to come to an end, divine settlement. Somebody say,
Lord, my God, I ask you,
divine settlement,
that you will
divine
be seen
settlement,
and that you
divine
will be
divine settlement,
Lord, my God,
divine settlement,
deception come to an end, all the plans, defenders from the wicked people, my Lord, my God. Defend the righteous, my Lord, and my God. Destroy the wicked one, my Lord, and my God. Remove them, my Lord, my God, so that the wicked one will be able to work again, my Lord, and my God.
Somebody is proclaiming,
my God, and Jesus, by the name of God, that somebody is announcing, we will have all the deep understanding
in the name of Jesus,
my God, standing for the Lord, that is understand you are God, my God, my God.
Now we are going to pray.
Amen.
As according to Judges chapter number 9 from verse 5, Judges chapter number 9 from verse 5. The Bible talks about the son of Jerubbaal, whose name was Abimelech, who went about in his father's house and killed 70 of his sons, 70 of his brothers, the sons of Jerubbaal, in one stone, in one altar. But the Bible tells me that there remained one who escaped. in Judges chapter number 9 from verse 5, and the Bible said that he went to his father's house at Ophrah and killed his brother, 70 sons of Jerubbaal, on one stone. But Jotham, the youngest son of Jerubbaal, was left because he hid himself. And this is what we're going to pray. Divine escape. We are going to pray divine escape of the remnant of God. We are going to decree and declare divine exemption. Divine, let our nation be exempted. Let Africa be exempted. Let the remnant of the Lord be exempted. Divine exemption. Divine escape from this coronavirus. In the name of Jesus. You know, most of things that are attacked, it is the church, it is the economy, it is the economy, the church that is attacked. Because what the devil wants to do, he wants us to lack what to eat. He wants us to crave the crisis to accentuate. But let's pray divine exemption.
Yes, Lord.
Divine escape in the economy.
Yeah.
Divine escape for the church.
Mm-hmm.
Divine escape. Let the remnant of the Lord go free.
Mm-hmm.
Declare that we are the Jotham of the Lord. Our nations are exempted from the curse of the virus. In the name of Jesus, let's pray. Kabasuta. We pray divine escape. We decree divine exemption. When the people are going to cry, we will not going to cry. Divine escape from hell, from death. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, let the Lord, let the remnant of the Lord go free. Let the remnant of the Lord escape. Let the remnant of the Lord don't struggle. Father, we pray and we decree and declare, let our economy escape. Let our churches escape.
Yes,
let your people be exempted.
Yes,
the consequences from the aftermath,
yes,
the aftermath of this,
yes,
plague,
yes,
of this virus,
yes,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
we pray divine exemption. We pray for the release of the blood to cover us. Let this thing pass over us. In the name of Jesus. Let it not affect the church. Let it not affect your people. We are the children.
Let us escape, Lord.
Those who are dying, Father God, we pray divine exemption.
No power, divine
escape. Let the church not be affected,
my Lord, my God.
Let the church not be affected,
my Lord, my God.
Let the remnant of the Lord not be affected.
We declare it, my Lord, my God.
When the statistic will come,
we declare, my Lord and my God,
when the statistic will come,
that the people will know, my Lord and my God,
that Africa is exempted, that the churches is exempted, that the pastors are exempted, that our leaders are exempted, that our family are exempted.
Go on,
my God.
The COVID-19 agenda, any agenda from the evil forces,
Jesus, mighty man. I just decree and declare.
Asia and Oceania and Europe.
I decree and declare when the status will come back, when it shall be said and done, they will count the death and they will find none among our people. Our servant of God, our men of God, our leaders, and the church. I decree this and I declare this divine exemption and escape from our children, from the church, and everybody that concerns us, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.